Dear students, today our topic of discussion is polymerase chain reaction. Polymerase chain reaction is a very important topic in the subject of genetic engineering and recombinant DNA technology. In this topic, what we will be dealing is not the mechanism, which is already known to you. The mechanism of polymerase chain reaction has been already studied in the previous classes, in the previous semesters. So in this video, we will be mainly dealing with the different types of polymerase chain reaction. What are the different facets? What are the different properties on the basis of which the polymerase chain reaction has been executed? How the different steps of the polymerase chain reaction has been modified and altered to get a proper mechanism of polymerase chain reaction, proper amplification of the DNA. Polymerase chain reaction is mainly the amplification of the DNA, that is how the number of DNA templates can be increased to increase the amount of DNA present in a particular sample, which can be utilized or which can be used to treat different type of problems or solve different type of crime problems, different type of analysis, disease identification, and many type of other applications. Now, before moving on to the different type of PCR, different mechanisms of the PCR, we will first try to understand what is the different type of applications of PCR. On the basis of the applications only, different type of PCR has emerged and has evolved. So, coming on to the applications of PCR, the first application is molecular identification, second is sequencing, third is genetic engineering. Okay, by all the three types, we are moving on to the first variety, that is molecular identification. Now, molecular identification we means particularly identifying a particular molecule, a particular drug or a particular compound which is responsible for carrying out a particular function in a system. So, under this molecular identification, some sections are divided, like molecular archaeology, molecular epidemiology, molecular ecology, DNA fingerprinting and classification of organisms, genotyping, prenatal diagnosis, mutation screening, drug discovery, genetic matching, and many others. So, this different type of sections under the molecular identification is nothing but how this PCR can be employed to improve the mechanism of any process, like in case of classification of organisms. So, how a classification organism can be benefited from PCR? When we are doing PCR, we are magnifying or we are increasing the DNA content. When we are increasing the DNA content, we can easily identify the particular characteristics of an organism, and when we know about the particular characteristics of an organism, we can easily identify how a particular organism can be classified. So in this way, the DNA fingerprinting also, we are doing the blotting, we are doing the electrophoresis. For all these things we are very much in need of increasing the content of DNA, because in the in forensic science, the amount of sample available is very less amount of DNA is available. It is very much essential to increase the amount of DNA present in a particular sample so that it can be analyzed for DNA fingerprinting. Now, moving on to the next step, that is the sequencing one. The next important application of PCR is sequencing. In sequencing, what we mainly do is, aspects are bioinformatics, genomic cloning, human genome project. So, what is happening in sequencing means how we can know about the perfect sequence of your nitrogenous bases or the gene sequencing. So, for that reason, PCR is very important. Until and unless you magnify the amount of DNA present in a particular sample, you cannot go for sequencing or you cannot increase the identify a particular problem. So, for that sequencing purpose, some tool you are required. So, the tools are bioinformatics, genomic cloning, and human genome project also requires huge knowledge of sequencing. And for sequencing purpose, you have to have to increase the total amount of PCR present in a particular sample. Now, coming on to the next category, that is a genetic engineering. Genetic engineering is a broad topic. Actually, it comprises of many aspects of molecular cloning, then your molecular biology, then your many DNA related aspects, protein, and then RNA. All these aspects are governed under the genetic engineering. Any engineering or any changes made in the gene of any particular organism will come under the category of genetic engineering. Now, this can be done through two ways, like site-directed mutagenesis and gene expression studies. These are huge areas of molecular biology. Each of the areas is dealing with a huge amount of data, huge amount of information. So all these things can be only when can be understood or can be analyzed when we are using PCR to increase the amount of DNA present in a particular sample. So another important, we can somehow understand what are the applications of PCR. Now moving on to the next thing, next main category, which I have already was talking about, like your the variations of PCR. Variations of PCR. Why we need modifications of PCR? Why we are always bent upon trying new varieties of PCR? Because the conventional way of PCR or the conventional way of the mechanism of PCR has some fallacies, have some cones, which we try to solve it. Because the problems we are facing using the conventional type of PCR has directed us to go for a new concept. We are changing or modifying each of the steps in each of the cases, and we are inventing different types of PCR based on our demand, based on our basis of work. So on the basis of that, we have invented a versatile techniques which is mainly suiting our purpose of applications. Now the first variety is the multiplex PCR. Multiplex PCR is a widespread molecular biology technique for application of multiple targets in a single PCR experiment. What is a multiplex PCR? By multiplex we mean multi means many. So in this type of PCR experiment, many targets are there which is getting multiplied in terms of single PCR experiment. Now in this type of PCR, there are multiple initiation sites from which a different PCR is undergoing. So the main important aspect is that you can amplify different types of DNA in a particular single reaction in a less amount of time. So that means one target can be amplified by using multiple pairs in a reaction mixture. This is one of the main reason of implementation of the multiplex PCR. Then moving on to the other important factors is that it requires very less amount of material. That means it requires very less amount of enzyme and other raw materials. So you require less amount of resources and you save a lot of money. And then annealing temperature of each of the primer must be optimized to work correctly within a single reaction. That means annealing temperature is the main controlling point where it has been changed so that all the annealing temperature of individual reactions can go forward, and depending upon their temperature, the things can get magnified. So, and which can be, after all, the result can be visualized in the gel electrophoresis. Now, coming to the types of multiplex PCR, single template and multiple template. Single template means there is only one template from which the primers are getting attached and the amplification is going on. But in multiple, there are multiple templates. That means same reaction contains different initiation site and which lead to the formation of different amplification of a particular DNA. So this is all about, this is an idea or overview of the multiplex PCR. Students, we will be concluding in this slide. On the next class, we will be continuing with the more detailed aspect of the multiplex PCR. Thank you.